Good morning. Thanks for tuning in. Well, having seen a pretty significant decline yesterday, the ASX 200 down 1.5%. We're set to kick off in negative territory once again this morning with a decline of 0.33%. And that reflects what we've seen in the Northern Hemisphere overnight, where stocks have tended to move lower and we have tended to see long and short-term interest rates move higher for a variety of reasons. So let's kick off in terms of the European experience last night. One thing that got everyone's attention, or has done for the last couple of nights, actually have been figures pointing to higher inflation. We saw higher wages figures in the UK a day earlier. And then last night we saw the July reading for consumer inflation. The headline level annualized at 6.8%. So that came in above the market's expectations of 6.7%. But significantly, the core was hotter than what the market was looking at. So the core is what we tend to focus on intently in terms of what inspires central banks. That strips out food and energy. The core rate was expected to come in at 6.8. It came in at 6.9%. So that discussion continued in relation to where UK rates in particular are going to top out in the medium term. There are 0.25% rate hikes scheduled for the next 2 months. And of course, the risk is that they could potentially go higher. So we saw a pretty substantial move higher for long and short term UK interest rates last night. So 2 year gilts were up by 7 basis points, 10 years up 10 basis points to 4.63, the 2 year gilt at 5.16, and that was what unsettled the UK equity market. The FTSE was down by around 0.4%, the French market down 0.1%, and the German market just in positive territory. In terms of the spread of performances for European stocks, we tended to see banks underperform. Real estate, travel, and technology were also leading decliners. Retail stocks did a little bit better. We had Marks and Spencer shares, one of the reasons that that index was higher. So they have delivered better than expected earnings, and they have had an encouraging outlook, and that contributed to that stock being up by around 4.5% last night. As far as the British pound was concerned, it also moved ahead quite significantly, unsurprisingly, on that higher than expected inflation reading against the US dollar. So there weren't many currencies last night that did well against the greenback, but the British pound was one of them. So one of the other important outcomes across the Atlantic last night was the release of the minutes from the last US Federal Reserve Open Market Committee meeting. And within this, the discussion turned around the concern relating to inflation and the need for interest rates to potentially go higher in the near to medium term. And that was another factor that was pushing interest rates higher, particularly where US markets were concerned. So whilst the moves were somewhat contained in terms of the move higher for yields, a 5 basis point move higher for 10-year Treasury notes to 4.26%, a 2-year Treasury note only up by 2 basis points to 4.97%. But what we are seeing now is multi-month highs where these yields are concerned. They seem to be moving into another range, indicating that the expectation around where interest rates are going has shifted as well, with the risk being to the top side. And that's what was troubling US stocks in particular last night. So technology names were under pressure. You had the NASDAQ finish the session with a loss of 1.2%. The S&P 500 was down 0.75%. The Dow Jones was down by about 0.5%. So the Dow provided a good cross-section in terms of the way that the various sectors were performing. So you saw banks generally weaker. Goldman Sachs shares were down by 1%. Boeing was down by 1%. Caterpillar, another example of industrials under pressure, down by 1%, with a similar decline for McDonald's. Procter & Gamble, a rather defensive stock, down 1.5%. And Intel, an example of the pressure that was being brought to bear on the tech space. It fell by 3.6%. Just an aside, so in recent days, we have seen a big move higher for US steel shares, with Cleveland Cliffs, another important player in the steel space, making a bid for US steel. And last night it was reported that ArcelorMittal, the European steelmaking giant, could potentially be interested in US steel as a takeover prospect as well. So that's something to keep in mind. In terms of the Commodity picture. So unsurprisingly, with those bond yields moving higher, we saw upward pressure on the US dollar, which is now at a two-month high. And as a result, that was tending to create downward pressure as far as commodity prices have been concerned, which saw oil prices sink to a three-week low. So there's been that interplay between slowing Chinese growth and tightness of supply in recent times, and the tightness of supply has been winning out, but that shifted towards the Chinese growth picture last night, and that's why we saw a downdraft for energy prices last night. Gold was down by more than 0.75% as well, and we saw quite a casualty being made of the Aussie dollar. So it has been downgraded for a variety of reasons, a more dovish stance from the RBA, the weaker wage numbers that we saw a couple of days ago, and then, of course, the strength of the US dollar. So last night we saw the currency move from 64.8 US cents to be around 64.2, which in itself, you know, that big decline in the Aussie dollar is inflationary as well at the margins. So in terms of what we can expect today, there's a massive day in terms of companies reporting their earnings, too many to point out, but it's being headlined by Telstra. And then on top of that, we've also got unemployment figures to navigate as well, which will be central to the conversation around interest rates in the near to medium term. The employment market has been holding up very well in recent times, and it's a question of whether or not that continues this month. That will be important, particularly for the Aussie dollar, given how much it has fallen in recent times. So that will arguably be one of the first areas to respond to today's employment figures. So a lot to get around. I hope you have a good day. I'll talk to you again tomorrow.